Time now for a rink demo presented by Bauer here with Johnny and Weeksy. And Weeksy, I'll apologize to you and the goalie union in advance here because, Johnny, you were saying this is one of your favorite things. When a skater comes down on the netminder and just kind of lays it in there, silky smooth, five hole. Take us through it.
One of my favorites, despite not being able to ever do it. I mean, it really was not my move. But what I remember, Peter Forsberg, all-time great Hall of Fame player. He was so good at selling the shot and then very cheekily, very slowly sliding at five hole while he opened up the goaltender. I'm like, well, that's pretty. And you know, I like anything that's going to be pretty. It's going to be a nice move. So we've seen a lot of them because goalies are so good now. Guys have to use deception and shot fakes. And I saw a great one from Michael Bodker. He opened up Martin Jones and was able to slip at five hole. Now, keys to this move. You got to sell the shot a little bit and pull it hard laterally to open up the goaltenders. But the key that I found out the hard way while trying to do this over and over is that it's actually a bit easier for lefties than righties. And we'll explain why momentarily. You see Bodker going on Jones, hard pull to his backhand, and then slips it slowly five hole. Celebrate as you would. So I see Peter Forsberg do it. I want to do it.
Right.
So I'm a righty, though. That's the problem. I'm a righty. So we'll explain as a righty why this is hard for me. So I'm coming on a breakaway. I got lots of speed, like Michael Bodker. I'm going to sell the shot fake. And then as I pull it laterally, here comes the goalie. Now watch the problem when the goalie slides. His stick moves with his body. He has no choice. It's attached to his front leg. So as he goes across, that stick will always slide with him. So when I go to pump fake, thank you, Kev, up and down.
Of course,
pump fake, pull it laterally. There's a stick, and I go to go five hole. It's there.
Yep.
Now, occasionally you can hit it.
Sure.
Like you might make the move.
Sometimes
you might
the stick
miss
goes
a stick.
Over just a touch.
Maybe the stick's over. Maybe it's on its heel like this and get up underneath like that.
Right.
But it's far less likely to work for a righty on this move. And I would try it. Okay. I play with Kev. He saw me practice over and over. I got you, Weeksy. I got nothing.
Nothing.
Over and over and over. And yet we watched the highlights this week. And look at all the guys. We'll roll the clip here. All the guys in the last week that have used this move to great effect. Dylan Larkin in overtime. Tremendous speed, sells the shot fake, opens up Garrett Sparky Finley. Drive a Mack truck through that five-hole Weeksy.
Straight down Yonge Street.
Right down Main Street is right. And the key to watch as you watch these highlights is where the goaltender's stick is. Because when a lefty pulls off this move and makes the goaltender move laterally, the goalie has the option of leaving the stick behind him. As he's pushing from right to left, the stick can, in fact, be left on the right side of his body. If he does that, it opens up the five-hole. Brilliantly, like Garrett Sparks. It was huge. Now that one, Harlamov's moving with the puck a little bit, but his stick's not quite in control because you're pushing so hard to cover up the wide move that the stick is up on your, it's off the ice, it's on your hip, it's on your knee, and these skilled players are able to slip a five hole. John DeJuan, he's about as smooth as they get. Yeah, we like that one very much. Domi DeJuan, we've heard a lot of that in Montreal. And hard pull, Craig Anderson can't quite control stick position. And so he's able to slip at five hole. So this is the advantage that lefties have in this move when they pull it off versus a righty. So now I'm playing left-handed, part of my poor stick handling. So same idea. So now I'm Bodker coming in. I sell the pump fake. I pull it laterally, Kev. Now if you push, if you're pushing as hard as you can and you're dying to get over there, sometimes the stick gets left over here. And then that, as its leg extends, then I got the five hole to knock it through.
Mm-hmm.
Or same thing. I come in, sell it, pull it wide. There it is. If I can hit the thing, and he leaves it over there. It's just an advantage that lefties have because of the stick position. Now, Kevin, as a goaltender, I'm sure you're probably taught to try to control that stick as you move. But it's hard when you're reacting and pushing it as hard as you can.
For sure. I look at it like tennis. You have your forehand, you have your backhand.
Right.
And in a weird way, as a goalie, as you pointed out, as a righty when you're executing that against a regular-handed goalie, not a southpaw, but a regular-handed goalie, when you're making that move, the stick goes with you.
It's a natural move.
It's with you. Yeah. It's here. It's on the right side of your body. Yeah. You're going right. But now the lefty is going the other way, and the stick is, you have to bring it with you. It doesn't go with you.
Mm-hmm.
So quite oftentimes you end up leaving that stick, or it doesn't seal your five hole quite properly.
And a lot of those instances, and we had one the other night where the guys are coming in and they're starting the bike there.
Oh,
what is a goalie, like, why does that get you to commit on something?
You know what? A lot of guys won't talk about it. And I, quite honestly, I never heard any player talk about this except for Tangs. Thank you, Tangs, on behalf of the goalie union, because he talks about false information and shooters trying to give goalies false information. But it's never been spoken before. But you'll get a head fake. It'll be a shoulder fake.
Yep.
It'll be a glove fake. Sometimes it's a foot fake. It's even skate fakes.
Yeah.
So they're giving goalies a lot of misinformation, hoping that the goalie's going to bite on something, and therefore makes it easier for you to execute your move offensively.
When you're going to start the bike, A lot of guys, when they shoot, mm-hmm. they need to lean on their stick so they get a little body weight transfer, get their stick in, their foot in the air, lean down on their stick to release it. Yeah. So if I come on a breakaway, I go like this, Cavs think that puck's gonna get shot. Then if I don't shoot it, then I have moves opening up. So all that false information trying to fool you. But again, it goes back to my original problem.
Yeah.
I shot right, I love this movement. I couldn't do it against goaltenders because their natural stick movement when you shoot left, decided advantage on this move specifically, trying to get it going five full. Nice and slow.
All right, start the bike.
Start
we're
the
out of here.
And get out
I'm
of
going
here.
To make my 4-year-old a lefty.
The game is a gift. You can visit your local retailer or Bauer.com for great holiday hockey gifts.